So it weighs about 35 pounds. This is a 12-foot one. And there's actually a fin that goes right on the back of it that I'm going to put on before I get out.
Should we get your dad on here with us? Yeah. Do you think your dad could stay dry like you guys know? No?
We don't often get quite this much enthusiasm. It breaks the world.
We're halfway through the show and I think I'm on half their energy.
Beautiful. So folks, I'm going to show you this right now. This is a handlebar that actually goes on this paddleboard. It just slides right in. I'm going to show you how quickly this sets up. Where it is locking in place. And then there's two little control knobs on the bottom. I hook up the rudder line. And then I literally just slide it in the water. So I grew up in a canoe camp, and when I saw these pedal bikes, I thought they were super gimmicky. It just looked too funny. Then we tried them, and now we have two in our place. And I'm going to show you some of the fun that you can have on these.
Oh, so, great, you're taking the whole eclipse out.
We're going to get the eclipse out, then we can have another race.
Oh, fun.
So these are actually the flippers that I can put in. So when you paddle, this is what propels it through the water. Much like the dorsal fins of a dolphin or a fish, this is what provides the majority of the propulsion in the water. I'm going to pop them right in. Just put down the two paddles, and literally I can sail away. So, like a paddleboard canoe or kayak, I like to just move it back and forth, get used to the feel of it. And this may look a little silly at first, but these are really fun. Especially when you have a couple of them, and you can literally just cruise down the lake like you're walking, you're talking to someone right next to you. Or if you want to, like, they go at a pretty good speed. If I want to get a real workout on this, I move my feet way back. So just my toes are on the board, and when I crank on it, I can really feel the burn all through my legs. So you can really adjust how you want to use it. Now the controls where my hands are right here aren't brakes. No brakes on these. This actually controls your direction. And one thing you don't want to do on these is get a lot of speed up and try to cut a real tight corner right away because you're very top heavy and you can go over.
You know another great thing about those ones are? A stand-up paddleboard, you don't want to get out when it gets too windy or choppy. But with that one, does it ever move quick even through a bit of wind and chop, doesn't it, Bill?
Yeah, the shape of it, the waves just roll over. And the other thing that I really love, Michelle, is on a day when there's a real strong headwind coming in, these just cruise right into the wind. We're going to race, Michelle?
Sure, you're having your leg day, I'm having my arm day. And as you can see, it does move us a little bit quicker. Oh no, I feel pretty good. I think I'm in good race shape, Bill.
They're pretty close in speed. Nice. Excellent. Our safely contingent is getting ready.
And the great thing, if you don't want to have a leg day, you can have an arm day and convert that to a paddleboard.
So propane motors this year, guys? What horsepower are they about?
What's that?
9.8. So guys, the sea fleas are shortly going to be on the water here. And if you haven't seen them, they are so cool. They're the real little wood motorboats one person goes in. And they actually have propane motors. And you're not going to believe how fast they can go in here. It's really cool to watch. A little bit faster than a paddleboard. We really like the quiet part of the sport. Michelle, why don't you show people one of your favorite things to do on the board when you're by yourself?
Absolutely nothing.
Nice. That's the beauty of these guys. You can take a dry bag with you, you can take your camera, you can take food, take a water bottle, and you can go out for the day. You can cruise around, and the fun thing to do is absolutely nothing on a sunny day.